Hey everyone, hope you're having a fabulous Thursday. Thanks so much for tuning in for day four of the author tips for book week that I'm sharing with you. Today, I mean, we've covered so much already. We've covered the authentic story, we've covered connection to self, and yesterday, connection to story. Today, we are going to be covering the last and final piece of the connection, and that is to your audience. So today, this is going to be the topic. This is my book, Ignite and Write, The Mindful Author. And this is going to be our section on today's video. So all of the content and much more is actually included in my book and is the foundation of the Ignite and Write workshops, which are coming up next month. And I'll tell you a little bit more about those soon. So when we talk about connection to audience, it is so important to make sure that you understand who your ideal reader is. So who is it that you actually want to pick up the book? I've lost count of the number of times where I've connected with aspiring authors and I've asked, you know, who's your book for? Who do you feel like can experience or draw the most from your story and from your message? And I kid you not, almost 100% of the time they will say, oh, it's for everyone, or, you know, or anyone can read it and they'll pick something up from it. So while that may be true, when you sit down to write your book, it is so important to have an actual ideal reader in mind. And when I say ideal reader, when you're talking about, say for a marketing perspective, any marketer will say to you, you need to have a target market. You need to have a niche or someone who very specific in mind that you want to reach out to, that you want to sell your product to or your service, whatever it might look like. And actually, writing a book is no different. So while we could have a book that could be relevant to everyone, it is actually impossible to write for everyone. So the reason why it's so important to really hone that down and get clear on who your ideal reader is that you can then communicate to that person. So instead of trying to use languaging or stories or anecdotes or information and present it in a way that is relevant to everyone, which is tiresome and impossible, you can direct all of that to your ideal reader. So it's so important to spend some time just really honing in on who that is. So I found when working with a client in my writing mentorship, for example, we did a process that we also do in the Ignite and Write workshops. And she was able to really think about who it was that would really light her up if they picked up the book and took something away from it. And for her, it was actually a dear friend of hers. Her book was about her cancer journey. And for her ideal reader was a dear friend of hers who actually passed away from cancer. So she didn't make it through the journey as so many people have. So she said, like, that's my ideal reader. That's who I want to inspire and give hope to, because I feel like if she had this book in her hands, her journey would have been so much lighter. So how beautiful is that for starters? And secondly, it really just helps to show, you know, who your ideal reader could potentially be. It could be someone you know, it could be someone you've never met before, it could be the avatar of who you target in your business or who the majority of your clients are in your business. It could be so many different people, but it's important to know who your people are. So I am going to show you a sneaky peek of one of the pages in my book. I hope that comes up okay. I think it is backwards. But this diagram here just shows why it's important to have an ideal reader. So your ideal reader sits up here. And the reason why I use the bell curve is because it shows that even though your ideal reader, this is where the majority, hopefully, of your readers will end up being. Just because you've picked an ideal reader doesn't mean that you are excluding everyone else who doesn't fit that category. So there will still be people, and I think on here, you know, I've got people, someone who's close to your ideal reader will drop in here. Maybe they're a different gender, or maybe they have different life circumstances or a different socioeconomic bracket. They could be different for a number of reasons to who you've pegged as your ideal, but they will still come to you and take something away from your message and read your book. And down here, we've got someone who picks up your book and buys it just because they like the front cover, or they're drawn to the title, or, you know, they've seen you on Facebook and they're curious to find out more about you. So there's going to be so many different people who will still pick up your book and take away something incredible from it. So yes, every book does have the potential to reach everyone and anyone, but as a writer, it's just so important for you to hone in on who your ideal reader is. And we do have an incredible process that we go through as part of the Ignite and Write workshops that really help you to identify who your ideal reader is. So if you are looking at coming along to the next Ignite and Write workshops, they are going to be in person on the Sunshine Coast on the 16th and 17th of September. And there is also another day on the 14th for those who would like to join online and get access to the incredible full day experience, where you get to really lay those strong foundations for your book and have everything in place, including a bespoke structure that you can write to when you sit down and actually channel that incredible creative energy, that passion, that enthusiasm in a really productive and efficient way to get that book created. So because this is Book Week, and I do love celebrating Book Week every single day, even when it's not costume dress up day, I am offering bonuses for anyone who signs up for the Ignite and Write workshops this week, and they are to the value of $150. So first off is my Ignite and Write book, fresh off the press, only just launched last week, and accompanying that is the Ignite and Write resource pack that I have created. So it includes books on ebooks on how to become a resilient author, how to become a successful author, and also how to start to plan out your book structure. So you can actually hit the ground running as soon as you sign up with all of these incredible resources. And then when we actually connect in person or online for the Ignite and Write workshop, you will be on fire and ready to launch in and make this happen. So I have popped the link below for anyone who's interested in more information on the workshops, or if you know that you're all in, you can sign up right now and I will get those resources out to you. So I wish you all the best, and I will see you again tomorrow.